Hey guys, what's going on? This Reddit video is going to be completely different from the previous ones that I would usually record. This is mostly in response to one of the videos I came across, posted by someone whose account name is called I Hate Everything. On his video, you can look it up. I'll bring it up in the description below. It's basically called I Hate Anxiety and Stalkers, and I can really relate. There are a lot of stalkers out there, far and wide, wanting something from someone, anyone, for no strange reason. Even the most, I don't want to exactly say anything threatening about certain people, but basically they're the most despicable you could ever come across. Like, I'm gonna tell you this right now, I've had a share of great encounters with stalkers that I really didn't like. Stalkers that would offer me something from certain websites that I would decline just flat out. But I don't want to start off directly from there. I don't usually do YouTube videos the way others do. I especially don't try to post videos the way PewDiePie does it. I mean, that's just not me. But I do post YouTube videos in response to certain issues that I have, which is the whole reason for my rage videos. This one in particular, I can really relate in regards to the one video Mr. I Hate Everything posted. I can really relate to that. I love technology. I really love technology. Sadly, it's the banality of what everyone can do nowadays. Music artists are going the, I don't want to say dangerous route, but they are being risky about their artwork nowadays. Especially Miley Cyrus. She's especially that little dictatorship of a certain foolishness that I don't even want to mention. But of course, with technology, you can basically do whatever you want. Expose whatever you can and, you know, express so much artwork just by posting things online. Things that are inspired by your interests and your experiences, especially in life. But that is the dark side of technology, especially in the internet. The internet has vast wide information to bring about, and basically with information comes great detail, and you have to be responsible for that. You have to be responsible for every information you put out there online. And if you're not responsible, then there's a problem, because you may be facing a lot of legal charges against you. And if you don't have anything to back up your reasons for sending out information, let alone your responsibility, then you're in deep trouble, you know? I have a lot of social media websites. The ones I'll mention are Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I especially have a problem with Facebook because basically I have friends on there who have friends who are basically doing a lot of stupid things, and I really don't like that. And one of the things I encountered on Facebook is one where one of my friends has a particular friend just going out posting stupid things that I didn't like and I had a personal problem with. And I tried dealing with that issue myself without actually telling a friend of mine. Basically, this stupid person just tried defending herself, saying that she's not going to remove anything that she just posted. That I could say I felt was discomforting another account. That's another mention of my friend. Basically, that thing that she posted, it was removed by Facebook. They knew it was a violation to their policies, but apparently that stupid person who posted it in the first place didn't seem to really care any about that. So she's probably still riled up about that to this day. But you know, that's mostly how I feel about Facebook. Facebook is just the most problematic thing for me. I really wish I'd come off of Facebook. Pretty sure I might be able to do that, but not anytime soon because, you know, a lot of other things going on that I really haven't discovered at all yet. But also, there are a lot of followers that I have on my Twitter account. Now, of course, most of the Twitter accounts aren't very dangerous for me, but there There are a few dangerous ones that I've encountered, and I look into just see about the offer that these certain followers are giving to me, which I decline straight off. But it's not just on Twitter. I want to say this before moving on. I hate the phone that I have right now. It's an Android from T-Mobile. And a long time I wanted a Droid, probably for Christmas or for my birthday or whatnot. But it just seems that for some strange reason, I was given a T-Mobile Android for my birthday. And I was really trying to get used to it. Just there are certain errors on the phone that I really did not like, and I really wanted to deal with this as soon as possible. Now you might be thinking, why not do it now to get this over with? Well, it's due to my schedule, I guess. I have college, first of all, and because I have college, I could easily do other things instead of dealing with certain problems that I have. I mean, I really want to deal with it soon, like really soon. But because of my schedule, it's not like I would actually forget, but there are certain things that I have discovered. And because of my schedule especially, I have to deal with that. So it really takes a while for me to get to what exactly I want to deal with. But back to the issue I have with Twitter. One of the Twitter accounts that's dangerous that I looked into, it was a stalker, basically. I don't know if it's a he or a she, but basically, this stalker was trying to offer me something, and I just declined it flat out. And recently, I blocked that account because of the encounter I had. But it's not just on Twitter, it's on my T-Mobile Android. A lot of strange texts were recently coming up, and especially on my Instagram account on my phone, which I'll explain later. But basically, these stalkers came out of nowhere, mostly from Yahoo, trying to offer me something, and I declined it. And I tried contacting the Yahoo corporations about the issue, and to this day, I haven't heard back from them. It's just how business works, I guess. But also on Instagram. Now, I don't have much of a problem with Instagram yet, but of course a lot of recent stalkers have been offering me similar things. But there's one quote unquote stalker, not exactly a stalker, who has tried to offer me something. This person liked my account for whatever reason, and she just decided to follow me. Couldn't really tell if she was a teenager, but that's just how confusing the internet is, especially social media. If you encounter a teenager and you can't really tell if that is a teenager or if that's just someone who wants to follow your account, then that could really screw up your mind. But it's not like I wanted to exactly disregard this person. I started following her, see exactly what she's trying to do. And so far, I have no problem with this person. So far, no offers were made to me. But you have to really be careful with those accounts that are following you for whatever particular reason and for whatever offer they're trying to give you. But yeah, other than that, I really like social media. I really like the fact that social media is out there so that you can communicate with a lot of people around you. Even try contacting people you may have once had a problem with. And basically, especially elitists. You may have had a problem with those elitists. It could be celebrity or corporate figure. But because of the internet, you can find out more about the elitists and see about the understanding you could get from their biography, basically their lives. But it's not like they're the banality of human existence. They're really not. I have no problem with them now. But it's like there are a lot of things out there that you have to look out for, especially nowadays, when even the smallest people you can encounter are stalkers. They are trying to offer things to you or want something from you that you really want to protect with your very life. So, yeah, I can truly relate, Mr. I Hate Everything. I can truly relate. I really hate how these stalkers are coming up out of nowhere, just trying to get to your social media accounts or your phone number and try to contact you and try to offer you something that you really don't want. It's just mind-blowing, personally. So, yeah, I can really relate. I understand what you're dealing with, and I support you, so you're not alone. I'm in the same boat, and if there are others who are in the same boat, you can let me know, or you can let the others know. You can even let Mr. I Hate Everything know. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you liked the video. If you did, subscribe. I'll be seeing you on the next Rage video or other. Alright then, I'm out.